Galaxy 1959 Fairlane 500 Galaxy. It's going to be all one colour. You know, sometimes I do them two-tone, but I think doing it all one colour, it should look pretty good.
You've got all new chrome.
Yeah, I've got all new chrome. I had the bumpers. Bumpers were dented. You know, and that's pretty rotten, but I've had them straightened and chromed. Done them. Should look, when it's done, it should look good. In fact, when I saw this car at the cruise about 3 years ago, it looked terrible. It's all jacked up with side pipes on it. I may not say too much about that. It goes to geezers. The engine. It's pretty bad. I've got to spray this. I mean, it's northern customising. This is, look at that. That's what they do.
I've had the car now for 3 years in various forms. It's taken on the street racer look, the lowrider look with having front hydraulics. But I decided this time to go the whole way of the early 60s custom, lowering the car. And every item on the car, the Lakes pipes, the Appleton spotlights, the tube front end, the Lucas spotlights, are all period items which would have been done round about 58 to 62. On the south coast of America. You've got a record player in there, which is actually an early 60s record player. It plays 14 discs. It's not working at the moment, but it's quite good. Back then, the people that would ride around in this car would probably still be in high school, and they'd cruise the local boulevards at night. They were considered by California surfers to be HODADS, which is a term given to them. They weren't interested in surfing and they usually had slick back hair. This was really the end of the era of the customised car, because after this, 63, 64, all the major motor manufacturers started to develop what are known as factory muscle cars, where the engines were hopped up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
It did, in fact, when at Daytona, 1 year came first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. The average lap speed was 215 miles an hour. They marketed their cars basically for young kids. The adverts were started off, the kids were about 14 years old, and some of the adverts said that the furthest you'll be able to drive the car now is to the end of your garage. I'm in love with the modern world. It used to be yellow, then I had it purple, and now it's gangrene. Or limelight, as Chrysler call it. They were all 60s colours. So that's what I like. Roadrunner was. At the beginning of Roadrunner, the second version, by Jonathan Richmond, it starts off by saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, Roadrunner, Roadrunner. I always thought that this was connected to when you usually start a car like this, you pump the throttle 6 times.
Roadrunner twice.
Another point, fast cars don't have vanity mirrors.
When I got my car, it was red and white, in a right state. I wanted to customise it, and it had to be an early custom. So I took the door handles off, lowered it, de-chromed it, the works. I put a 57 Ford bonnet on it, 57 Dodge Lancer hubcaps, Lucas spots, tube grill, everything. Now I had it sprayed a wine blue, lacquered. The interior is tuck and roll, and a guy in Hayes done it near where I live. And, it is a real nice job. Because I took the door handles off, I had to have some way of getting in the car, so I fitted electric solenoids. And there's a button inside. I also fitted one on the boot. I wanted just the car just to look good and be an early customer. And that's what it is.
Okay, this is a 1930 Model A Ford. I imported the car from America about 3 years ago now. It cost me $3,000, which then was about £1,500. It wasn't in the condition you see it now. I've more or less rebuilt the whole car. The engine came with the car, but as you can see, it's had a lot of new parts added. It's automatic transmission, and it will do about 0 to 60 in 6 seconds. The vision is quite good considering the roof has been lowered 3 inches. Okay, well, I try not to use the car with a hood. I put a lot of work into that engine and I'd rather show it off. So, weather permitting, the hood doesn't go on, and it causes a bit of concern with the local constabulary, but they understand.
Every last Saturday of the month, we go cruising, which is the main cruise route for here is King's Road and the Albert Bridge. There's several other cruises in London, but this is the biggest and the best there is. You know, I mean, for us it's a whole way of life. Our social life and our friends all drive these sort of cars. You know, we wouldn't really have it any other way.